Assalamualaikum and good morning to all my students. So today, you will learn chapter 1, Introduction to Statistics. So we continue. Subtopic 1.3, Data Collection and Sampling Techniques, and 1.4, Role of Computer in Statistics. So data collection methods. So we have 6 methods here, okay? So number 1 is face-to-face interview. Number 2, telephone interview. Number 3, direct questionnaire. Number 4, mail postal questionnaire. Number 5, direct observation, the most commonly used. And the last one is other methods such as email and video recording. So let's look at an overview of sampling techniques. So what is a sampling technique? Sampling techniques is a scientific method of selecting sample from population. So we have 2 different techniques here. The first one is probability sampling technique, and the second one is non-probability sampling technique. So what is the difference between these two? Probability sampling techniques, in which the subject of the population get an equal opportunity to be selected as a representative sample. Okay, but for non-probability, it is not known that which individual from the population will be selected as a sample. So this means that probability sampling technique is more systematically than non-probability sampling technique. And we can see that probability sampling technique, we get ready the population and we know at first which sample we will take from that population. But non-probability, we just got a random population and sample to be taken. So here is a basic non-probability sampling techniques. So under non-probability, we have 4 sampling. Okay, 4 type of sampling. The first one is convenient sampling. Second one is a quota sampling. Third one is judgmental sampling. And fourth is a snowball sampling. So we look at the first sampling here, convenient sampling. So convenient sampling collect sample from a conveniently available pool of respondents, and members are readily approachable to be a part of the sample. Okay, so the keyword here is available pool of respondents, and members are readily approachable. For example, when companies distribute their promotional pamphlets and ask questions at the mall or on a crowded street, so means that you go to the crowded places, okay, because we know that at the crowded places, you can choose any sample to be your respondent, okay. So we go to the judgmental sampling. The sample members are chosen only on the basis of the researcher's knowledge, okay. Researcher's knowledge and judgment. For example, a group of researchers interested in learning if the reason why people wear eyeglasses is to read books. So their sample is people that indeed wear eyeglasses. Okay, so you choose sampling that are related to your research, okay, to your studies. For the quota sampling, form a sample involving individuals that represent a population and are chosen according to traits or qualities. For example, researcher might ask for a sample of 100 females. So, or 100 individuals between the age of 20 to 30. So, we have target sample to present a population. Okay, that is a quota sampling. And the last one is a snowball sampling. Research participants recruit other participants for a test of study. The sample group is said to grow like a rolling snowball. For example, researcher is studying environmental engineers but can only find 5. First, we find 5. But she asked these engineers if they know any more. They give her several further referrals, who in turn provide additional contacts. In this way, she managed to contact sufficient engineers. From 5 sample, we can grow up our sample into much more respondents. So here is the strengths and weakness of each of non-probability sampling. Okay, so when you look at the snowball sampling, the strength of snowball sampling can be estimated rare characteristic, but it's time consuming. Okay, while for the convenient sampling, less time consuming, less expensive, and most convenient, but the sample not representative and quite biased. Okay. And judgmental sampling, seems to be a convenient sampling. It's less expensive, less time consuming, and most convenient, but it does not allow generalization and very subjective. Okay. For quota sampling, sample can be controlled for certain characteristics, but same as the convenient sampling, is quite biased and no assurance of representativeness. So we go to basic probability sampling techniques. So same to the non-probability, we have 4 techniques under probability sampling techniques. The first one is a simple random sampling. Okay, and then we have systematic sampling, stratified sampling, and the last one is a cluster sampling. Okay, so probability data is one in which the chance of selection of each subject in the population is known before the sample is picked. Okay, so we have 4 methods, as I mentioned before. So we have a random, systematic, stratified, and cluster. Okay, so we look at the random sampling first. Okay, so for example, we have population here. So we have 12 person in one population. So each data is numbered and the data is selected using chance or random method. Okay, for example, we numbered each of the person here, 1 to 12, and then if you want to take the sample, for example, we want only 4 samples. Okay, so by randomly choose the number. Okay, so by randomly we choose number 2, number 5, number 8, and number 10. So that is a random sampling. But first, you need to number each of the sample in that population first. Okay, before you take it as a random. Okay, while systematic sampling, okay, so each data is numbered. Okay, same to the random. First step, you must number the sample. Then the data is selected every kith number. Where, so we have some formulation here. So K equal to capital N divided by N. So capital N is a total number of sample in population. Okay, means that number of population, but N is a sample. Okay, so what size of sample you want to take from that population? Okay, so by using that formula, okay, so look at the example. For example, we have 12, okay, person in that population. Okay, by using the formula, so K equal to capital letter of N divided by N. So 12 divided by N, you'll get 3. Okay, so means that every third you will take as a sample. Okay, so 1. Okay, start with the 2. Okay, for example, the first sample, we start with the 2. The second person. And then every third. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So every third person, you'll take as a sample. That is a systematically sampling. Okay, for stratify, okay, the first step, you must divide it into groups according to some characteristic. Okay, for example, here we divide into 3 groups. Okay, the blue one, red and green. Okay, then the sample is selected from each group using random or systematic sampling. Okay, so we have 3 groups here. 1, 2, 3. So each group, you must take a sample. Okay, so first group, we take person number 10. Second group, we take person number 2 and 8. And the last group, we take person number 5. That is a stratified. Okay, for cluster sampling, same to the stratify, you need to divide it into groups. But, okay, you must choose all members from those selected group. Okay, all members from those selected cluster are chosen. Okay, for example, we have 6 group here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so you need to choose those selected cluster. Okay, all members on that cluster. So example here, we choose cluster number 3 and cluster number 6. Okay, all members on that cluster. Okay, you must take it as a sample. So this is the strength and weakness of the probability sampling. So we look at the cluster sampling. Okay, so the strength of the cluster sampling, easy to implement, cost effective and work is reduced, but it is imprecise, difficult to compute and to interpret the result. Okay, for the stratified sampling, include all important subpopulation. Okay, but it's difficult to select relevant stratification variables and not feasible to stratify on many variables, and it's quite expensive. Okay, systematic sampling, easier to implement than simple random sampling, but can decrease representativeness if certain pattern exists in sampling frame. Okay, so simple random sampling, easily applied. Result can be projected on population, but the weakness is difficult to obtain, sampling frame expensive, sometimes no assurance of representativeness. So this is the role of computer in statistics. So in statistics, okay, so the computer can do for data collection, okay, data entry, data checking, data screening, definite analysis, and presentation of your results. So computer is very important to present, to analyze your data. So thank you. That's all for chapter 1.